In 2017, a third of Hillary Clinton voters said Donald Trump was not legitimately elected.
They didn't,
and you're
they
saying
didn't
this
take
is
the same kind of actions that we
exactly.
saw.
Exactly, and we
absolutely
there is no
that is the escalation.
As we heard, there were vocal opponents of the president, thousands of them protesting across Washington throughout this day. Most of them were peaceful, but a number of incidents turned violent late this afternoon. A limousine was set on fire downtown. Smoke could be seen for blocks away. And protesters hurled trash cans, flash bombs, and objects at police who used pepper spray in return. By this evening, at least 217 people were arrested. Six police officers were injured.
We're going to ask you a lot of questions today, Mr. Elder, mostly on the state, but since the governor of California will also be a leader in the nation, we want to address that. So the question I would ask next is, among conservatives, there is a growing quorum who distrust elections and election officials, including in California. Do you trust in the integrity and validity of California's elections process?
I know Donald Trump has been accused of fomenting the big lie. If I had a nickel every time I watch CNN, and I watch a lot of CNN, I watch Chris Cuomo and Don Lemon and Wolf Blitzer. If I had a dime every time they said Donald Trump has pushed the big lie, I could self-fund my campaign. I want to point out that for 4 years and counting, Hillary Clinton referred to the 2016 election as having been stolen. Her word, not mine.
Can you give a direct answer? You will accept the election?
I have to see. Look, you. I have to see.
Another alarming obliteration of presidential and democratic norms.
Trump knows he's an illegitimate president who got illegitimate foreign help.
He knows he's an illegitimate president. He knows that there were a bunch of different reasons why the election turned out the way it did.
You can run the best campaign. You can even become the nominee. And you can have the election stolen from you.
I know that he knows that this wasn't on the level.
Why do you think the president is going to such great lengths to essentially prove that he beat you?
Because he knows he didn't. He knows he's an illegitimate president.
I do think that he knows he's an illegitimate president.
She referred to Donald Trump for 4 years and counting as illegitimate, her word, not mine. When the Senate investigated the 2016 election, they made two major findings. One of them was this, that despite their efforts, the Russians failed to change a single vote tally. Yet, according to a YouGov poll, a respected poll, 66% of Democrats believe that the Russians changed vote tallies. One more time, the Senate report found zero evidence that the Russians changed a single vote tally. Now, the politics editor of CNN is a man named Chris Cillizza. He wrote a piece where he excoriated Republicans for, quote, falsely believing that there was, quote, widespread voter fraud in the 2020 election. 76% of Republicans, he said, believes this lie. 78% of Democrats believe that the Russians, quote, changed the outcome of the election, close quote, in 2016, even though the Senate report could not find any evidence one way or the other. Mostly what the Russians did, as you know, is buy a bunch of Facebook ads, some pro-black, some anti-black, some pro-Trump, some anti-Trump, some pro-Hillary, some anti-Hillary, in order to just stir up discontent. But the Intel report found no evidence whatsoever that the Russians changed the vote, changed the outcome of the election or not. Yet 78% of Democrats, according to Gallup, believe that the outcome of the election was changed by the Russian interference in 2016. Yet Hillary's social media was never shut down, even though she was promoting the big lie. Social media, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook never shut her down, even though she was promoting the big lie. Now, when I say that, people push back and say, well, Hillary conceded the election, Donald Trump did not. Google Donald Trump and concede, and you'll find numerous articles where Donald Trump conceded the election. I agree he didn't concede it right away, but ultimately he did. And neither Hillary nor Donald Trump used the C word, concede. The second pushback is, well, Hillary did not sue to overturn the election. Au contraire, mon frere, she joined Jill Stein in Jill Stein's lawsuit to overturn the election in Wisconsin and filed a separate motion to have the recount done by hand.
Said something. Well, he said a lot of things that were troubling, but he said something truly horrifying. He became the first person running for president, Republican or Democrat, who refused to say that he would respect the results of this election. Now, that is a direct threat to our democracy.
That's horrifying. You know, every time Donald thinks things are not going in his direction, he claims whatever it is rigged against him. That is not the way our democracy works.
Hillary Clinton, once horrified at the prospect of President-elect Donald Trump daring to question the results of the election, now joining Jill Stein in demanding a recount in Wisconsin. And here to weigh in, Democratic Ohio State Senator Capri Chaparro and Kristen Tate from the LibertarianChick.com. Thank you both for joining us this morning.
Absolutely, thank you.
So, no longer a threat to democracy, Kristen?
This is just the height of hypocrisy. I mean, of course, when Trump wants to question the results if he loses, you know, that would be appalling. But now that Hillary's the one that lost, she's completely changed her tune.
Third, Hillary's supporters did not storm the Capitol on January 6th. That is true, because Hillary was not president on January 6th. But on election night in November 2016, there was widespread violence on the part of Hillary supporters all over America, including clashes with the police, including police cars being burned. And on the third week of January in 2017, when Donald Trump was inaugurated, 200 people were arrested in Washington, D.C. because of violent protests. That's almost half of the 400 people that were arrested on January 6th.
A limousine was set on fire downtown. Smoke could be seen for blocks away. And protesters hurled trash cans, flash bombs, and objects at police who used pepper spray in return. By this evening, at least 217 people were arrested. Six police officers were...
So let's move from this rather controlled scene to this uncontrolled scene.
Cars and smashed windows. Protesters dressed in black, their faces covered, armed with hammers and bricks. Facing off with thousands of officers on site, many in riot gear, confronting them with flashbang grenades and pepper spray.
I personally have anti-establishment slants, but I don't think that this is anything that I want to be a part of.
So, I believe there's a double standard here. Donald Trump has been pounded and pounded and pounded for promoting the so-called big lie. Hillary has promoted the big lie for 4 years and counting and has never, ever been, in my opinion, upgraded over that. And finally, Donald Trump, to my knowledge, never referred to Barack Obama as having stolen the 2028 election or the 2012 election, and never referred to him as illegitimate during the 8 years of his presidency. But Hillary, as I repeat, referred to Donald Trump as having stolen the election in 2016 and being illegitimate. I think there's a double standard here, and I wish the media would acknowledge that.